The stock photos app on iOS has come a long way since the days of iOS 6, when it used to be just a bare bones gallery app. Now it packs in a ton of handy features to help you organize your photos and videos, but it still falls short in some areas. Which is why I'd suggest that you try out a couple of third-party gallery apps that offer even more utility. If you aren't sure which apps to try out though, you have come to the right place. Hey guys, this is Abhijit from Guiding Tech, and in this video, we'll be taking a look at 5 amazing gallery apps for the iPhone that you must try. So without further ado, let's get right to it. Kicking things off is the usual contender, Google Photos, which is arguably the second most gallery app on iOS, and for good reason. If you haven't used Google Photos before, then you should definitely check it out as it packs in a boatload of features. With the app, you'll obviously be able to browse through all your images and video, but then you can also use it to take quick backups of all your photos to your Google account and make use of Google's AI-powered features like visual search, smart sharing, and automatic albums. On top of that, you also get access to Google Lens, which you can use to identify text and objects in your photos, which is reason enough to get the app right away. But before you do that, there's one thing you should know. Google Photos, along with all the other apps in this list, will ask for access to your photos to function properly. This could be a cause for concern for some of you privacy-conscious folks, so if that's the case, then you shouldn't be using any of these apps. Next up, there's a slide box which comes with handy gesture support that aims to help you easily organize your photos. Frankly speaking, I rarely organize the photos on my phone, but ever since I've started using this app, my gallery is so much more sorted. Now just take a look at this. I can swipe left or right to move between the images. I can swipe up to instantly delete an image, tap on Sort to Album button to add it to an album, long press on it to share, and tap on it to zoom. Isn't that simple? Now let's take a look at My Pics, another great option that packs in a ton of organizational features. With the app, you'll be able to create albums with custom album art and themes, view all your media in a neat calendar view to see when you took the photos, or open them up in a map to see where they were taken. On top of that, My Pics also comes with a handy photo editor built in that you can use to spruce up your images before posting them on Instagram. Now, speaking of Instagram, have you checked out our account yet? Well, you haven't, then drop everything right now and click on the link in the description or look us up on Instagram as Guiding Tech, because we have been working hard on posting some really cool photos on the daily. We are also hosting some Instagram exclusive giveaways, and we would definitely like you to join us there. Moving on, Tidy Gallery is another great photo management app that you can try out. It also includes easy swipe navigation like Slidebox, but the implementation is a bit different. You can tap on either side of the display to browse through your photos, swipe right to keep an image, swipe left to delete, and drag them into the folder icons on the side for easy organization. The app even has some cool filtering options with which you can locate large or duplicate files and remove to save some valuable storage space. Rounding things off is Gallery Vault, which, as the name suggests, gives you access to a lockbox in which you can hide sensitive photos or videos on your iPhone. The media can be protected using a password or even Touch ID, provided your phone still has that. And you can even disguise the app to prevent anyone from accidentally stumbling across your vault. The app also has a break-in alert feature, which will send you an alert if anyone tries to break into the vault, and it will also capture a photo of the perpetrator so that you know who tried to snoop around in your phone. However, that's only available in the Pro version. Well, that rounds it up for this video. Make sure to try out these gallery apps and let us know which one suits your needs the most in the comments. If you've been using a third-party gallery app which has made your life easier, then I'd love to know about it. Please do share with us in the comments. And this is Abhijit signing off for this one. I'll see you guys in the next one.